Hi, it's Jill from Jelly Bean Studio. I hope you can join me today for some fun in a craft notebook junk journal. Welcome to the channel, or welcome back. I'm glad you could join me today. So we are currently in June 2023. I've been working in this little craft notebook. It's the Pen and Gear brand, and I'll link the last video. The coffee, thank you. That I started the setup for this process. It's very similar process to the composition notebook junk journal. Simple to do. This was 30 pages that I glued together, so I have 15 to journal on. Made some new printables. Those I will also link below. They are free. And if you click on the Ko-fi app, that is the little coffee cup, I hope you enjoy them. So in the front of my journals, I typically put a pocket, not always. Have a couple here. I have one on the top, little scrappy bits in it. I don't really do a monthly calendar. I know a lot of journalers do. I tend to just write notes and such. I've also been coming off the 100-day project, which ended June 1st, and I was doing 100 days of scraps, so still plenty, and I guess I always have scraps, so part of my journal process for sure. And in today's video, I really, as I do a little journal with me, I hope you grab whatever you're enjoying working on and can chat, and I'd love to hear what you're doing in the comments below. And I also thought, sometimes, I don't know, the questions come up like, why do you journal, or how do you journal? So as I kind of make a few things today, I thought I would chat about that too. So the first reason that I personally journal is fun. I'm sure a lot of you, it's the same thing. I find so much joy in playing with paper, pens, paint, and just making things. So that's part of it. And then I also love keeping track of moments, like life's little moments. So that's sort of what I'm showing you. I'm showing quickly again those printables I made. And for me as a journaler, I tend to do 2 to 4 pages a week. That's why this notebook was perfect. 15 pages for a month is plenty for me. So pick the journal that matches you. You can always, of course, in journaling, add things. You can add little tip-ins and so forth. So the other thing that I've been thinking about lately is just the fact of a creative journal being a place where you can explore. You can do mixed media, if that's your thing. You can explore your feelings or memory keep. It's really a place of, I think, a place where you can grow as a person. Or just jot down what you had for dinner. There's, you know, it suits you. So for me, I think I do a little bit of that, a little bit of both. Like, there's breakfast on the left that I'm thinking about because we're having company come and family visit soon. And then there's that creative play that is sheer fun for me, playing with patterns and paints and pens and all the pretty things like this napkin. So yeah, those are just some of my ways that I really enjoy my journal. And I guess for a lot of people, they would call this visual journaling, because I feel like I do my journal, I would say almost 2/3 visual and 1/3 in writing and memory keeping. So for me, all of the little bits and pieces and colors and paints and pens are really a huge part of what I enjoy as a journaler. So anyways, I hope that's helpful to you if you're new or you want to try a new style journaling, maybe give you some ideas of a direction that you want to take. And boy, a little craft journal like this is so inexpensive, so easy to start with, and I think you just kind of have a place to play and figure out what you like. So recently in, this is the weekend of the, I guess it's the 10th and the 11th, yeah? We went to a local fair and that was really fun. I bought some local art, so that's what I was starting to journal about on that page. And also those bunnies. We have rabbits in our garden right now. And what I tend to do when I'm getting ready to gear up for a journal spread is I tend to just get ready for making so that I don't end up with a blank page. So I tend to put out on my journal table some supplies that I want to play with. These are some permanent, oh goodness, I don't know what's on it actually. There's something on it, but some permanent tempera paints that go on almost like chapstick. They're called quick sticks. So easy to just get down a little bit of color on your page. And then I tend to put out some scraps, magazine clippings, printables, digitals. Here's some stenciling, fabric scraps, packaging. And I think for me, that has helped me with my journal flow, that when I get ready to journal, since I don't journal every single day, I have something right there. Yeah, a lot of scrappy bits. And for me, it's simply a matter of, especially this stage of the journaling process, anything goes. It's pure relaxation. And oftentimes I'm looking at other channels, getting ideas and inspiration, figuring out what I want to do, how I want to do it. Sometimes there's journal challenges, like Junk Journal July is coming up. And many channels have some great challenges that, you know, you just try once a month or something, or once a week, depending on, you know, what you tap into. So I don't know, tap into is the word I want, but whatever you check out, you know your feed. There's always something that pops up that's interesting. So for the last part of today's video, I thought I would use some of the June printables on black cardstock and use a white gel pen for a little bit of journaling, written journaling, and making journaling tags and such. And the last piece I guess I really want to say is probably the most important thing to me when I started to share on YouTube, which is the main place I share. I've been trying to share on Instagram, but that needs work. Is connection. There is just so much out there in the journaling community and so many channels that you can subscribe to. And I think it's really important to support other YouTube channels, other creators, other creatives. Subscribe, like their videos, get them in your feed. And it happens 10 times over what you get in return just for that, that free little act of kindness, right? Because it just pops up. You're able to comment on what they're doing, get ideas. We share with one another. It's just a nice place, whatever social media you want to use, Instagram or YouTube, are sort of my places, but again, YouTube is kind of my main place right now. And then finally, supplies. So I think you can journal pretty simply. If you're a junk journaler, you're pulling in all sorts of papers and packaging. And I love that. I think it's actually representative of our everyday life. what coffee I'm drinking, what mac and cheese I'm eating. What did I pick up when I went out to coffee with a friend? And then other things you love, old vintage book pages, children's books, pens and markers. Here's a little bit of a seed packet. Yes, I am drinking right now the hazelnut Green Mountain coffee. And then just make your scrap piles. All of a sudden, I'm always surprised. And does this happen to you? I put a few things together, literally in a pile, not necessarily to use them in a particular spread. And then when I go back to them a day later, I realize, oh wow, that and that would make a really cute tag. Or this and this might be the background. So pile it up, friends, and get it together inside your journal pages if you have a chance, because that way, for me, in my journal practice, I don't like facing the blank page. And if you're anything like me, then that really helps you get into the flow in the time that you have, because all of us are on different schedules and in different stages of life. So for me, that makes journaling extra fun, is to have things kind of ready so I can just go for it when I'm ready. Okay. I hope that's helpful. I hope you're enjoying whatever you're doing lately. I would love to know if you're using the June printables. I'm very happy. I hope you enjoy them. I would love to hear what you're doing in your June journaling in general, and what supplies you love to use, what notebooks or journals you're making, all of the good things, right? There's so many ways to journal. And I think the best bit of advice I ever got was 100%, there are no rules. You make your own rules. You do what works for you. Okay, in this last little part of the spread, I'm going to use the door from my June printable. I'm going to stick a little bit of glue stick down here. And I think I'm going to do it half-see. It's more than half, the door on, so it will fit within the borders of the page. And use this as a journaling spot. I'm gonna jot a few notes about what's growing in the garden lately. I don't exactly know how to use this yet, but I like the bit of book page. And lately I've been really enjoying pens and paint. One of my favorites are the Uniball Signo gel pens. And I love the way how crisp and clean and fun it is to use on black. So I mounted the little digital door on black cardstock, as you saw in the beginning, and it makes a cute little tag or journaling spot. So we have right now in our garden tomatoes. It's a small garden. Basil, purple coneflower. I don't know, there's something about marigolds that are supposed to keep pests away from your tomatoes. Is that true? I have no idea. And we have some sunflowers, one of my favorite flowers. So again, I hope you enjoy the June printables if you use them and are having a good time with your June journaling. Thanks so much for stopping by. I really appreciate it. And I hope you very much enjoy your journaling. Thank you so much for watching.